I've been very honored to have associated with the CARE Group of Hospitals, which, as Dr. Riaz rightly mentioned, is one of the most ethical, one of the most honest organization in healthcare, which probably is thinking only to give the best treatment to its patients in the state of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh and across the country, and wherever they have their centers. Now, my association with the CARE Group as a bariatric surgeon is something which is very unique. It is unique because you have bariatric surgeons in your own city, Hyderabad. They are doing a fantastic job. And I have some of my friends here who do bariatric surgery, and they are doing a great job. But we are trying to do something new, something which is more innovative, more long-lasting, and more patient-friendly with the CARE Group of Hospitals. Now let me explain to you in details. So I am basically a bariatric surgeon. Bariatric surgery means surgery for weight loss, surgery for morbid obesity, surgery for patients who have a lot of weight. And what does a lot of weight means? That their body mass index is more than 30. And they have comorbidities like type 2 diabetes, hypertension, sleep apnea, coronary artery disease, a lot of lipid disorders, joint pain, back pain. In young females, there would be polycystic ovarian disease and menstrual irregularities. So this is a complex of metabolic syndrome, and we treat this disease by a surgical method. Now, this is being happening in the city of Hyderabad since like last so many years. But I have a different perspective to that. There are two issues in bariatric surgery which, as bariatric surgeon, as a responsible doctor, I should come and I should express to the media. And I think those of you who would have reported previously about bariatric surgery, there are three things which you would have reported. First of all, most of the journalists would confuse bariatric surgery with liposuction. They think that bariatric surgery is liposuction. So bariatric surgery is not liposuction. Liposuction is just removal of fat from the subcutaneous tissue, and that is plastic surgery, cosmetic surgery. We don't do plastic surgery. We don't do cosmetic surgery. We do life-saving surgery. And why it is a life-saving surgery? Because of this surgery, we not only help the patient to lose a lot of weight, but also help him to get his diabetes better, get his diabetes treated. As in, if the patient is on insulin, he can leave insulin after our surgery, or get a very good control of diabetes. His hypertension can be treated. His other associated problems, which I mentioned, like sleep apnea, menstrual irregularities, back pain, joint pain, can be treated. So this is not a cosmetic surgery. This is a very life-altering surgery, a life-saving surgery. But having said that, there are two problems which media has reported, which everybody faces. The first problem is the fear of surgery. So anybody who is in this particular specialty of weight loss and obesity and diabetes, they understand that there are a lot of stakeholders who claim that yes, we can treat obesity, yes, we can treat diabetes, yes, we can. You have a lot of them, starting from multiple treatments. I'm not going to go into the details, but to treat obesity, the treatment of obesity starts from home, where your grandmother can claim she can treat obesity, where everybody can claim. But the issue is that people are afraid of surgery. So the fear of surgery is the first thing which I am going to address. Bariatric surgery is one of the safest surgery. The data from Cleveland Clinic suggests that bariatric surgery has lesser rate of mortality and morbidity as compared to a joint replacement, a coronary artery bypass surgery, or a cesarean section. So they did this study, and it is published, where bariatric surgery probably has lesser mortality and morbidity as compared to all these procedures. So bariatric surgery is a safe surgery. The complications can happen in any form of surgery. We have seen complications happening in even a cesarean section, in even simple surgeries. Number two, still, having said that, when I put this data in front of you, most of the patients do not want to undergo surgery. They don't want surgery. I see patients regularly in my OPD. I've done 11,000 bariatric procedures. It's the highest in Asia Pacific, but When the patients turn to my OPD, if I see 50 patients daily who are morbidly obese, suffering from all complications of obesity, they don't want surgery. So what option do we have? Now just imagine, if somebody is a height of 5 feet 10 inches and his weight should have been 75 kgs, and suppose he's 100 kgs of weight. Now we don't want that person to lose the entire excessive 25-30 kgs to get rid of his comorbidities. Even if he loses 10 to 15 kgs, we are happy. In short, what I mean to explain is that we don't expect 100% weight loss for any individual. We know, and the data suggests, that even if you have 30 to 50% of excess weight loss, which you have, most of your diseases are cured, or maybe they get better with time. So why directly go for a surgical option? For individuals who do not want surgery, although I say that very clearly, bariatric surgery is the most effective treatment for morbid obesity, but individuals do not want to undergo surgery, then what is the option which we have for them? So to the city of Hyderabad, we bring a very novel concept, not novel in terms of the years this procedure has been practiced. This started in US way back in 2012, and it has been 7 to 8 years where the data is available. In 2011 it started, it's been 7 to 8 years. In India, we are doing this procedure since last 2 years. And this procedure is an endoscopic procedure. It's a non-surgical procedure. For people who want to understand, anybody who has in the hall who has undergone upper GI endoscopy, just to see whether your stomach has ulcers or it has some, whenever you have a stomach ache, you go to a doctor and he says, okay, I'm going to do endoscopy on you. And it's usually an OPD procedure. You go to the doctor, he gives you a little bit of sedation, does an endoscopy and comes out in say half a minute or maybe 30 seconds. It's like that. It's an endoscopic procedure where you don't have incisions on your abdomen. There is no big incision. There are no cuts on the abdomen. You go through the mouth and you perform the entire procedure. And what we do in this procedure, we reduce the capacity of your stomach by taking sutures, by sewing your stomach wall inside by endoscopy. And these are full thickness sutures which reduce the capacity of your stomach, the capacity to eat. And also, it stimulates many hormones which causes obesity, which causes diabetes. The procedure is known as endoscopic sleeve gastroplasty. It was performed in the Mayo Clinic way back in 2010 and 11 by Professor Abu Deyeb and by Professor Manuel Galvao. And then in United States of America, it has become the most common non-surgical method to lose weight. It is a permanent method. It has got permanent results. The data suggests that you lose somewhere around 60 to 80% of your excess weight. The results are parallel to the results of bariatric surgery in the initial some days, but at least 80% as good as bariatric surgery. So we want to introduce this to the city of Hyderabad. The care group has been kind enough to develop a fantastic infrastructure for the surgical, for the non-surgical endoscopic procedure. And I'm going to explain you how we do that procedure by a short video so that everybody understands that how this procedure is done. The discharge of the patient can be done in a single day. It's a day care procedure. There is no pain, no scar. The patient can resume his work from the next day, and the patient loses good amount of weight in the initial first 6 months. The procedure will be performed in the care group. And already I saw 3 patients, they are more than excited to get the procedure done. I am very happy because as a bariatric surgeon, I always thought that if the patient does not want surgery, what can I give him? We had the option of intragastric balloon. Some of you must have heard about the balloon therapy. The only problem with the balloon therapy is that it is very short term, it is not permanent. After 6 months to 1 year, you have to remove the balloon and then the entire weight comes back. So now we have a better procedure which gives a permanent weight loss, more weight loss than balloon. And we have done a lot of these procedures, umpteen number of them at Indore already. Also, we have done at Mumbai in Ahmedabad. And now we are launching it at Hyderabad. And hopefully this is going to be one of the most commonly performed procedure for obese, overweight individuals, type 2 diabetics, so that they can get some control on the portion size of their meal and get rid of their comorbidities. It is not necessary for everybody to undergo surgery, and we can do this very less morbid procedure and give almost equivalent results. The other concept which I wanted to talk about bariatric surgery is there is one more problem with the bariatric surgery apart from fear, and the problem is the concern about the weight regain. Let me tell you, at Indore I practiced bariatric surgery, and last 6 to 7 years almost 90% of our procedures have been banded procedures. Now what does a band means? If we do a surgery, we always put a non-adjustable ring over all our stomachs, which we reduce in size because stomach is an elastic organ and it dilates and enlarges with time. To prevent the dilatation of the stomach, we put a non-adjustable ring. These are known as the banded procedures, and we are introducing them for the first time in the city of Hyderabad with the care group, assuring that all those patients who undergo bariatric surgery at care group will not regain weight in future, will not have a recurrence of diabetes in future, will not have the other comorbidities coming back in future. Bariatric surgery is very good in the honeymoon period, but we want that the bariatric surgery should not only be safe, but it should be a long-term effective solution. So these are the two benchmark things which we are introducing with the care group. My intention of coming to the beautiful city of Hyderabad is to do something different, something more useful, something more robust, so that we together with this group create a difference in this space of obesity and type 2 diabetes. So again, I thank Dr. Riaz and everybody here. You have spared so much of nice time for me and for the group, and we hope that you are doing a great job because you are spreading this message across, and because of your message, some person who is in need of this surgery or who is afraid of surgery, who can get a endoscopic non-surgical procedure done, can come to us and have been treated. Thank you.